Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel. Now in today's class, we are going to discuss about the acceleration, velocity and displacement of the simple harmonic motion. Okay. In previous class, we have discussed about the differential equation of the simple harmonic motion. And that differential equation is d2x by dt square plus omega square x is equals to 0. So using this equation, we are going to derive first the acceleration. From acceleration, the velocity, and from the velocity, the displacement. Okay, so let's start with this equation. So as we know that the equation, it is d2x by dt square plus omega square x is equals to 0. Now we know that x is a displacement. So second derivative of displacement, it is nothing but the acceleration with respect to time. Okay, so d2x by dt square in this equation, it represents the acceleration. So directly from this equation we can get the acceleration. So how to get d2x by dt square? If we shift plus omega square x to other side, it will be minus omega square x. So d2x by dt square means nothing but the acceleration, it is minus omega square x. So this is the acceleration for the simple harmonic motion. Okay, now let's start for the velocity. Okay, now for velocity we are using this acceleration equation. What is that? D2x by dt square is equals to minus omega square x. Okay, now we separate this. Okay, so let's start with this derivation. Now observe this slide. Let's start with the derivation. So here we are initially starting with this acceleration expression. So what is that? D2x by dt square is equals to minus omega square x. So first we concentrate only on the LHS of this equation. So what is the LHS? LHS is d2x by dt square. So we will separate it. We will get here d by dt of dx by dt. Okay. So derivation of displacement dx by dt with respect to time, it is nothing but the velocity. So here we are getting it is dv by dt, rate of change of velocity with respect to time. So this is the change of d2x by dt into the dv by dt. Now just rearrange this equation. So for rearranging, we are using here multiply and divide with the dx. So dv by dx and dx by dt. So here multiply and divide this dv by dt with dx. So here dv by dx will separate it and dx by dt separate it. So from this equation we will get here dx by dt means rate of change of displacement with respect to time, that means here we are getting velocity. So this term converted into velocity v into dv by dx. So v dv divided by dx. So ultimately the LHS d2x by dt square is converted as v dv divided by dx. Okay, so in the next step I have written there v into dv divided by dx LHS is equals to RHS as it is minus omega square x. Okay, now separate the variables. Separation of the variables means what? VV terms will keep as it is to the one side and the remaining other terms will keep towards the another side. That means here V and DV, LHS as it is, and we shift DX with the right hand side, omega minus omega square x. So what is the equation change here? V dv is equals to minus omega square x dx. Now this is the differential equation, so we integrate this. Now integration apply to whole equation. So after application of the integration we will get LHS V dv integration of V, it is V square by 2. So LHS will become V square by 2. And RHS integration of minus omega square x. Omega square, it is a constant, so we will keep it aside from the integration sign. So outside the integration minus omega square. Integration of x dx only. So x dx integrated, then we will get here x square by 2. So the expression will come as v square by 2 is equals to minus omega square x square by 2. And according to the rule for the integration, we are getting one constant here. So that constant we get here represent, suppose it is with the c. Okay, so keep this constant as c in the right hand side with the minus omega square x square divided by. Now let's calculate the value for the c. Now how to calculate for the c? See here, we will use one condition, particular condition. What is that? When x is extreme, that means when x is equals to a, at the extreme condition, velocity it becomes zero. We always observe that in case of, suppose we take an example, in case of a swing, if you reach to a maximum position, we again return to the mean position. That means there is the end of the velocity. If velocity present there, again we will move in the further direction. But we return, that means the velocity ends there. Means at extreme positions always we will get velocity zero. So we use this condition here. If x is equals to a, extreme condition, a means amplitude, then v is equals to zero. So apply this in the above equation. What we will get here? V square by 2 is equals to minus omega square a square divided by 2. Instead of x, a substitute ke la. So minus omega square a square by 2 plus c. Now v is 0 means LHS totally 0 now. V square by 2 jemi bolle, that is nothing but the 0 here, because the condition says that if x is a, v is 0. So 0 is equals to minus omega square a square by 2 plus c. So what is c? Shift this. Plus omega square a square by 2 is nothing but the constant c. So this a substitute in the above equation where we get the first time that c. Okay, to substitute this value, we are getting now v square by 2 is equals to minus omega square x square by 2 plus, instead of c, attaji value of substitute find out ke liye that, plus omega square a square by 2. Now total equation in the denominator 2 is there, so we can take common and cancel out. Okay, so the remaining term is v square is equals to minus omega square a square plus omega square x square. So common, take common omega square, we will get here v square is equals to omega square in the bracket, so minus common na getlela, so x a square in the previous term, a square minus x square. Okay, so minus will remain as it is with the x. So we are getting here velocity as v square is equals to omega square in the bracket a square minus x square. So from this, what is velocity? Take square root of the total equation. V is equals to omega, since omega square, from the square root it will came out, so omega square root of a square minus x square. This equation will represent the velocity for the simple harmonic motion. Okay, so how to find this? From the acceleration equation. Okay, now we'll move towards the next concept, that is the displacement of the simple harmonic motion, or displacement of the particle in the simple harmonic motion. So for this we are using the velocity equation. Now what is velocity equation? We know that v is equals to dx by dt. Okay, so velocity, according to definition, it is nothing but the rate of change of displacement, that means dx by dt. That means here we can write velocity from the previous equation, we can use dx by dt is equals to square root of omega into square root of a square minus x square. So this is the velocity v. Now again separate the variables. How to separate these variables? Here dx by dt, dx remains as it is to the LHS. Square root of a square minus x square, this total term contains x. So we have to shift this square root of a square minus x square to the LHS. So it will come in the denominator of the dx. LHS la kai jala, square root of a square minus x square, x term aslamo x sobat ghayche. So dx divided by square root of a square minus x square ithe. And omega will remain as it is with transferred dt. So omega into dt will on the RHS. Now separation of the variable over. So now we apply the integration. Integrating the total equation. After integration, we will observe that this formula, it is directly for the sine inverse of x by a. The square root, dx upon square root of a square minus x square, it is nothing but the formula for the sine inverse of x by a. Okay. So, substitute, after integration, we directly substitute here sine inverse of x by a. And in the RHS, omega dt, that means here it is nothing but the omega t dt, integration will be t, so omega into t, and again here constant of proportionality, here we have to substitute alpha. So what alpha represents here? Alpha is the phase angle or phase of that particle at that condition. Okay, so we are getting ultimate here sine inverse x by a is equals to omega t plus alpha. Now solve this equation. Aplela kadaycha kay displacement x. So that sine inverse, if we shift to RHS, it will become sine. So x by a is equals to sine of omega t plus alpha. How to shift sine? Sine inverse will become RHS, it will be sine. So sine of omega t plus alpha. So last step, x is equals to shift a into sine of omega t plus alpha. And this is the expression for the displacement of the simple particle performing simple harmonic motion. The x is equals to a sine omega t plus alpha, where a is amplitude, omega angular frequency, t time, and alpha is the phase angle. Okay. Now there arises some special cases. So for that special cases, we will substitute some particular values. So let at initial time, that means time t is equals to 0, the particle will not displace, so x is equals to 0. Time t is 0 asel, the displacement started zalel nahi, so x will be 0. So substitute here in this displacement equation, 0 is equals to a sin omega t plus alpha. A shift kela 0 by a, it will be 0. So sin omega t plus alpha is 0. म्हणजे ह्या ओमेगा टी प्लस अल्फा काय आहे साईन सोबतचा अँगल आहे, दॅट मीन्स इट इज नथिंग बट रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ अ साईन थीटा. सो वेन साईन थीटा विल बी झिरो, वेन अँगल विल बी झिरो. सो ओमेगा टी प्लस अल्फा वेन एव्हर इट इज झिरो, देन ओनली वी आर गेटिंग हिअर एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू झिरो. दॅट मीन्स इनिशियल फेज इट इज झिरो हिअर. ओमेगा टी प्लस अल्फा इट रिप्रेझेंट्स इनिशियल फेज, मीन्स पार्टिकल ऑलवेज स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द mean position, then displacement will be zero. This is the first condition or first case. The second case, if particle starts from the extreme position, म्हणजे initial condition is त्याने extreme position start केली असेल. So for that, t is 0, then x is a. Means initial condition t 0 and x extreme means highest amplitude a. So in this case, if we substitute here, we will get here a is equals to, x is a now, a is equals to sine of a into sine of omega t plus alpha. Now here a divided by a, it is 1. So sine theta, now here we are getting 1. So when sine angle is 1, when it is 90 degree or 270 degree. So when we are getting the extreme position, then phase angle will be 90 degree or 270 degree, and that is the condition when body starts from the highest point, that is the extreme position. Okay, so these are two cases we have discussed on this basis. Okay, now again there are some conditions, that what are the extreme values of displacement, velocity and acceleration on the basis of these equations. Okay, so how to find the extreme position? See, so first we consider that the displacement starts from the mean position. So whenever it starts from mean position, we know that the angle will be 0 degree. So here x is equals to a sin omega t plus phi. Here we are getting the sine value as 0. So 0 into a amplitude, it will become 0. So displacement will be zero. So when a particle starts from mean position, its phase angle will be zero and the particle has initial displacement zero. And if it starts from the extreme position, then for the extreme position x will be a, and we are having the phase angle pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2, means 90 degree or 270 degree. And for these conditions, the sine value will be plus 1 or minus 1. Okay, so if we apply this condition, we are getting here the value of displacement as plus or minus of a. A means amplitude here. Okay, so plus a amplitude in upper direction, minus a means amplitude in lower direction. That means we are getting here extreme condition, particle performs when from extreme position, it will be either on the positive extreme position or on the negative extreme position, plus a or minus. So similarly, we'll discuss for velocity and acceleration also. Now we know that at mean position x is 0. So the velocity of particle will become, we know the expression for velocity, v is equals to omega into square root of a square minus x square. So when mean position x is 0, what the expression changes? V is equals to omega square root of a square only. So a square will come out from the square root. So this is the maximum value of velocity, that is a into omega, maximum possible value of velocity. So we are getting maximum velocity at the extreme positions, hence it is represented as V max. And if the particle starts from the extreme position, x value is a, so substitute in velocity equation, V is equals to omega square root of a square minus a square. X is a now. So a square minus a square 0. 0 multiplied by anything will be 0. So velocity we get here 0. Means at extreme positions of the simple harmonic motion, the velocity it is found to be 0. So at mean position velocity is maximum, at extreme position velocity is 0. Now consider the acceleration. What is the formula for the acceleration? It is minus omega square x. So when body starts from the mean position, x is 0. So acceleration will also 0 by this equation. Okay. Means at mean position, displacement 0, acceleration also 0. Now at extreme positions, x will be plus or minus a. So acceleration will be changes minus omega square multiplied with plus or minus a. That means acceleration will be plus or minus omega square a. This is the maximum possible value of acceleration, and we are getting this at the extreme positions. Okay. So from these three conditions, one conclusion is there, or we can say the two conclusions about mean position and the extreme positions we can derive. At mean position, displacement 0, acceleration 0, but maximum is velocity. At extreme positions, displacement maximum, acceleration maximum, but velocity is 0. Okay? So extreme position la aplyala fakta velocity maximum milte, ani mean position la velocity 0 milte. Baki je sagle highest. So these are the discussion about the velocity, displacement and acceleration of a body that performs the simple harmonic motion. Okay, so we have to derive with the help of differential equation only. First to find out acceleration, from the acceleration find the velocity and then the displacement, and apply only the simple concepts of the mean position and extreme position, then we will get the overall expression. So hope you understand here each and every step. If you have any doubt regarding any step, please comment here, I will explain there. And if you like our videos, share it and subscribe.